In the last lecture, we have discussed about theorems on probability. In this, the last section is in multiplication theorem on probability, when events are independent or dependent. In which we have discussed, if events are dependent, then their conditional probability, and in second case, when events are independent, then in such cases, probability of happening events simultaneously in a random experiment. In that case, if events A and B are independent, if event A and event B are independent, then their complement event node A and node B are also independent. We can prove easily this one by the previous axiom and definition. Probability of A bar and B bar, simultaneous occurrence of complement of event A and B, is equal to probability of A union B bar, because of by De Morgan's law, event A union B bar is equal to intersection of their complementaries. So in this case, we can write probability of A intersection B bar is equal to probability of A union B whole bar. And therefore, probability of A and B bar, or A intersection B bar, equal to probability of A union B whole bar by De Morgan's law, which is equal to 1 minus probability of happening of event A union B. Now, probability of A union B, because of events A and B are independent, so event cannot be mutually disjoint. And if events are not mutually disjoint, then probability of occurrence of event A or event B equal to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A and B. Now, event A and B are independent events given in the question. So, probability of A and B is equal to probability of A into probability of B, which is multiplication of their individual probability. Now, 1 minus probability as it is, in second and third, fourth term, 1 minus probability of A minus probability of B common, 1 minus probability of A. 1 minus probability of A common, in these two parts, we get 1 minus probability of B. And therefore, 1 minus probability of show, probability of their complementary event A bar and probability of B bar. Therefore, probability of simultaneous occurrence of two complementary events is equal to multiplication of their respective probabilities, and therefore A and B are independent, then their complementary are also independent. For example, if the manager X settling the wages problem of with the workers is given by probability of X equal to 1 by 3, and the manager Y settling the wages problem of with the workers is given by probability of Y equal to 2 by 3, then find the probability that wages problem will not settle, which means X bar and Y bar both not settle the problem. In that case, both are trying to settle the problem independently, and in that case, probability of X bar into probability of Y bar, multiplication of the individual probability, and therefore x bar and y bar are also independent, so we apply this condition and find the probability. Probability of x equal to 1 by 3 in this case, then probability of x bar equal to 2 by 3, 1 minus 1 by 3. And probability of y bar similarly equal to 1 minus 2 by 3, which is equal to 1 by 3. So 1 by 3 into 2 by 3 equal to 2 by 9. In 2 by 9, out of 1 game, problem will not be settled. So probability that the Bessel dispute will not settle is equal to 2 by 9. Now the next result is related to independent theorem. If A1, A2, A3 and AN are independent events with respective probabilities of occurrence, probability of A1, probability of A2 to probability of AN. In this case, probability of happening at least one of the event is given by 1 minus probability of none of the events can happen. Now we prove this one with help of independence and dependence. So first of all, probability of happening at least one of the event is given by probability of A1 or A2 or 2 or AN is equal to 1 minus probability of not happening of these events. By De Morgan's law, complementary union of events to union of AN is equal to intersection of their complementary events. So we apply this theorem on this condition, we get 1 minus probability of non-happening of event A1 and A2 and A3 to AN. And events A1, A2, A3 to AN are independent events, so they are complementary also independent, and in this condition probability of intersection of such events is equal to multiplication of their respective probability. So probability of happening at least one of the event equal to 1 minus probability of none of the event can happen. Probability of happening at least one of the event, that is A1, A2, A3 or AN, is equal to 1 minus probability of none of the events A1, A2, A3 to AN happens. Or equivalently we can say that probability of none of the given events happens is equal to 1 minus probability of at least one of the happens. For example, a problem in statistics is given to 3 students A, B and C whose chances of solving it are 1 by 2, 3 by 4 and 1 by 4 respectively. What is the probability that the problem will be solved if all of them try independently? In this question, first of all, the given condition is they solve the problem independently. So, first of all, the given part of the question, let A be the event that A solved the problem, B be the event that B solved the problem, and C be the event that C solved the problem. Now, problem will be solved. Let E be the event that problem will be solved. means problem will be solved, means at least one of them A, B or C solve the problem. And we can write the probability of A or B or C solve the problem, or probability of A union B union C. Now probability of, which means probability of at least one of these three students solve the problem. Now events are independent, then probability of at least one of them solve the problem is equal to 1 minus probability of none of them solve the problem, which is equal to 1 minus probability of A bar into probability of B bar into probability of C bar. Here probability of A, probability of A equal to 1 by 2. This implies that probability of A bar equal to 1 minus 1 by 2 is equal to 1 by 2. Probability of B equal to 3 by 4. So probability of B bar equal to 1 minus 3 by 4 which is equal to 1 by 4. And finally probability of C equal to 1 by 4. Therefore probability of C bar, that is, that means probability of not solving the problem by C is equal to 1 minus 1 by 4 which is 3 by 4. Put these values in the final result. 1 minus probability of A bar 1 by 2 into probability of B bar 1 by 4 into probability of C bar 3 by 4 is equal to 1 minus 3 by 32 which is equal to 29 by 32. So probability of problem will be solved is equal to 29 by 32. We can also solve this problem by another method in which events are not mutually disjoint, then probability of event E which is equal to probability of A union B union C, which means probability of solve the problem at least one of them. Events are independent, so event A, B and C cannot be mutually disjoint, and in this case probability of at least one of the event occur is equal to probability of event A plus probability of event B plus probability of event C minus probability of event A and B minus probability of event B and C minus probability of event C and A plus probability of event A and B and C. Now events A, B and C are independent, therefore probability of event E is equal to probability of event A as it is, probability of event B as it is, plus probability of event C minus. Now probability of A intersection, because of event A and B are independent, so probability of A and B is equal to multiplication of their respective probabilities. Similarly for minus of probability of B intersection C, probability of B into probability of C minus probability of C intersection A equal to probability of C into probability of event A. Plus all these three events are independent, so probability of A into probability of B into probability of C. Now put the values of probability of event A, B and C, which is probability of A half plus probability of B solve the problem 3 by 4 plus probability of C solve the problem 1 by 4 minus probability of A and B, which means 1 by 2 and 3 by 4 plus, sorry, minus probability of B into probability of C 3 by 4 into 1 by 4 minus probability of C and A. Probability of C 1 by 4 into probability of A 1 by 2 plus probability of 1 by 2 into 3 by 4 into 1 by 4 probability of A into B into C. LCM is 32. In first case 16 plus in second case 24 plus 8 minus 12 minus 6 minus 1 plus 3. So total is positive values 40, 48 and 51 minus 22 divided by 32, which is equal to 29 by 32. So results are same in both the condition because of we apply same condition, same criteria in this case. So probability of event A is equal to 29. Probability of event E, sorry, is equal to 29 by 32. If in the same question, probability of problem will not be solved if they try independently, which means probability that the problem will not be solved means A not solve the problem and B not solve the problem and C not solve the problem. And if event A, B and C are independent, then their complement are also independent. So probability of A intersection B intersection C, sorry, probability of A bar intersection P bar intersection C bar, simultaneous occurrence of these three events equal to multiplication of their respective probabilities, probability of A bar into probability of B bar into probability of C bar, which is equal to probability of A bar half into probability of B bar 1 by 4 into probability of C bar 3 by 4, 3 by 32. So these questions are related to previous results, which are related to independence of the theorems. Now, there are various situations where outcomes of an experiment dependent on the various intermediate stages. For example, a person has undertaken a construction job, the probability are 0.65 there will be a strike, and 0.080 the construction job will be completed on time if there is no strike, and 0.032 that the construction job will be completed on time if there is a strike. Determine the probability that construction job will be completed on time. So in this condition, let A be the event that construction job will be completed on time and P be the event that there will be strike. So construction job will be completed either with strike or with without strike. So A be the event and B bar be two events, and A be the event which occurs with B or B bar. So let A be the event that construction job will be completed on time and B be the event that there will be a strike. Given in the question, probability of B equal to 0.65, therefore probability of B bar, that means there will be no strike, is equal to 1 minus 0.65, which is equal to 0.35. Now the next given condition is conditional probability that construction job will be completed on time if there will be strike. So probability of event A when B has been occurred is equal to 0.32 given, and second part is conditional probability that construction job will be completed on time if there is no strike, which means probability of A when B bar has been occurred is equal to 0.80. Now, construction job will be completed either with strike or without strike. So, A can occur either with B or with B bar. There are only two possibilities, ki A occurs with B or A occurs with B bar. Therefore, probability of event AB union AB bar, which means probability these two events are mutually disjoint in this case because of A occurs. This part shows A B and this part shows A B bar. And if B and B are mutually exclusive and existing events, then AB and AB bar also mutually disjoint events. And in this case, by third axiom of additivity or third axiom of probability, which is axiom of additivity, probability of A intersection B union A intersection B bar equal to sum of their respective probability, which is probability of A equal to probability of A intersection B plus probability of A intersection B bar. Now, events are event A intersection B and event A intersection B are mutually disjoint events, and therefore such events are dependent events. Because if events are mutually disjoint, then such events are always dependent. So if events are dependent and B occurred first, then conditional probability or simultaneous occurrence of event A and B is equal to probability of B into probability of A when B has been occurred. This probability of there will be a strike and into probability of construction job will be completed on time with strike. Similarly, for second term, probability of B bar into probability of A when B bar has been occurred. Put the values of probability of B, probability of A by B plus probability of B bar into probability of A B bar. We get the result equal to 0.49. That means construction job will be completed in 49% case with or without strike. Now, in discussion of conditional probability, revising probability when new information is obtained is an important phase of probability analysis. We often started our analysis with prior or initial probabilities. Estimates for a specific event, then from the sources as a sample, as a product test or as a special report and so on, we obtain some new additional information about the event, and given this information we update our prior probabilities by calculating revised probability, which is referred as posterior probability. Bayes' theorem provides a means for making this probability calculation. In this, first we find, we know prior probability from the sources, we obtain some additional information about the event, and given this new information we revise the prior probability, which is known as posterior probability, with help of Bayes' theorem. Bayes' theorem statement is, if B1, B2, B3 to Bn be a set of exhaustive and mutually exclusive events associated with a random experiment, and an event A occurs either with B1 or B2 or B3 or to Bn, then conditional probability of specific event Bi when A is stated to actually occur is given by probability of Pi into probability of A when Pi has been occurred divided by total probability of A, or which is equal to summation of I varying from 1 to n probability of Pi into probability of A when Pi has been occurred. This is known as Bayes' theorem. In the Bayes' theorem, first important part is B1, B2, B3 are mutually exclusive or and exhaustive events. So these events combined represent the sample space, and probability of all these events is equal to 1 in this case. Outer circle represents a sample space which consists of event B1, B2, B3, B4 up to Bn. which are mutually exclusive and exhaustive events. And inner circle represents event A can occur with B1, which is represented by A, B1 or A and B1, or with B2 or with B3 or with Bn. Any one of these and mutually exclusive or exhaustive events. So, probability of A equal to. Now, in this case, events B1, B2, B3 to Bn are mutually exclusive and exhaustive, and by the figure, we can see that event A, B1, A, B2, A, B3 are also mutually exclusive and events, not exhaustive, only mutually disjoint event. And in this case, possibilities of occurrence of event A which means event A occurs either with B1 or with B2 or with B3 or with Bn, and these events B1, A, B2, A, B3, A2, Bn are mutually disjoint. So by third axiom of probability, probability of this event is equal to sum of their respective probability, which is equal to probability of B1 plus A plus probability of B2A plus probability of B3A2 plus probability of BnA. Now these events are mutually disjoint. So by our previous result, if events are mutually disjoint, then such events are dependent. So in this case, probability of B1A is equal to probability of B1 because of B1 occur first, into probability of A when B1 has been occurred. Similarly, for probability of B2A, probability of B2 into probability of A when B2 has been occurred. To probability of Bn, A is equal to probability of Bn into probability of A when Bn has been occurred. So events are mutually disjoint. So sum of their respective probability of union of these events is equal to sum of their respective probabilities, and events are mutually disjoint. So such events are always dependent. So in that case, probability of B1A equal to probability of B1 into probability of A when B1 has been occurred. We can write in abbreviated form, summation varies from I equal to 1 to n, probability of Bi into probability of A when Bi has been occurred. Again, probability of event A Bi equal to, if event A occurred first, then probability of A into probability of Bi when A has been occurred. And if event Bi occurred first, then probability of Bi into probability of A when Bi has been occurred. Since probability of events ABI and BI are equivalent, then their probabilities are also equivalent. So probability of A into probability of BI when A has been occurred is equal to probability of BI into probability of A when BI has been occurred. And through this condition, we find probability of BI equal to probability of BI into probability of A when BI has been occurred divided by total probability A, which is equal to summation of probability of Bi into probability of A when Bi has been occurred. So Bayes theorem is a revision process of the probability. Some remarks related to Bayes theorem. First is the probability B1 of probability of B2, probability of Bn are termed as prior probabilities because they exist before we get any information from the experiment itself. In second remark, the probability, conditional probability of event A when B1 has been occurred to probability of A when Bn has been occurred are likelihoods because they indicate how likely an event A under consideration is to occur, each and every prior probabilities. And the third part, the probabilities of Bi when A has been occurred, revised probability or posterior probability because determined after the results of the experiment are known. So in this case, when result of the experiment are known, we divide the probability of pi when A has been occurred, and this is known as Bayes theorem. We can display Bayes theorem in the following tabular form, in which first column present list of mutually exclusive and exhaustive events p1, p2, p3 to bn. Second column represent prior probabilities of these events b1, b2 or b3 to bn. In third column, we represent the conditional probabilities of new information if given each event b1, b2 or b3. So it is equal to probability of bi when A has been occurred. In the next part, in this case, probability of A when Bi has been occurred. Conditional probability of new information A given each event, which is probability of A when Bi has been occurred. Compute the joint probability for each event using the formula probability of Bi A. If event Bi occurred first, then probability of Bi into probability of A when Bi has been occurred. In the last column, we compute the posterior probability by using basic relationship of conditional probability or by Bayes theorem. So example of the Bayes theorem is as: for a certain binary communication channel, the probability that a transmitted 0 is received as 0 is 0.95, and the probability that transmitted 1 is received as 1 is 0.9, and the probability that a 0 transmitted is 0.4, find the probability that first one A 1 is received, and second A 1 is transmitted given that 1 is received. So in first case we find total probability, and in second case we find a conditional probability of event transmitted 1 given that 1 is received. So first we convert into mathematical form, or for this first we assume the events. Event P1 represent event of transmitting 0, and event P2 represent that the event of transmitting 1. Clearly P1 and P2 are mutually exclusive and exhaustive event, and therefore total of the probability of these events is equal to 1. And let A be the event that receiving 1 either be transmitted 0 or transmitted 1 events. Now given probability of B2 equal to 0.4, probability of transmitting 0 is equal to 0.4, therefore probability of transmitting 1 is equal to 0.6, because of total probability is equal to 1. So probability of B1 plus probability of B2 equal to 1, because of B1 and B2 are mutually disjoint, and probability of B2 are known, which is equal to 0.4 plus probability of B1. B2, sorry. Probability of B1 equal to 0.4, and probability of B2 as it is equal to 1, and therefore probability of B2 equal to 0.6, which means probability of transmitting 1 is equal to 0.6. Now next given condition is the probability that transmitted 0 is received as 0. Probability of transmitted 0 is received as 0. So event B occurred first, transmitted 0, and in that condition receiving 0, which means A bar. If A represent receiving 1, then A bar represent receiving 0. So probability of A bar when B1 has been occurred is given by 0.9. Similarly, the probability that transmitted 1 is received as 1, which means probability of received 1 when transmitted 1 is equal to 0.90. Now if I therefore the probability that a transmitted 0 is received as 1, probability of transmitted 0, received as 1 means probability of receiving 1 when transmitted 0 is equal to 0.05, because of this is equal to 1 minus probability of A bar when P1 has been occurred, which is equal to 1 minus 0.95 equal to 0.05. Therefore, the probability of a 1 is received, first part of the question, probability of a 1 is received. Now, 1 received either with 0 transmitted or 1 transmitted. So, these two are only possible events favorable for event A, and these events are also mutually disjoint, because event A occurs either with B1 or with B2 in sample space, and therefore these events are also mutually disjoint events. And mutually disjoint events, then for third axioms of probability or axioms of additivity, probability of such events is equal to sum of their respective probabilities. And events are dependent, so probability of B1 into probability of A when B1 has been occurred, plus probability of B2 into probability of A when B2 has been occurred. After putting the values of P1, probability of P1, probability of P2, and conditional probability of A when B1 or B2 has been occurred, we get the result is equal to 0.56, the probability or possibility of that a 1 received is equal to 0.56, or 56% cases we received 1 when transmitted, 1 or 0 transmitted. Now, the second part of the question is, a 1 received or a 1 transmitted, given that 1 is received. So, given condition is the 1 is received means probability of 1 transmitted, which means probability of P2 when 1 is received. We find this probability by Bayes theorem, which is equal to probability of P2 into probability of A when P2 has been occurred, divided by total probability of event A, or total probability of A 1 is received, which is equal to probability of A. So, probability of B2 equal to 0.6, probability of A when B2 has been occurred is equal to 0.9, divided by probability of A, which is equal to 0.56, 27 by 28. So, in this condition, we find the revised probability of receiving 1, transmitting 0 or 1 with the condition that receive 1, event A. We can also solve by tabular form, in which first we, in the first column, we represent the mutually exclusive and exhaustive event. In this condition, there are two mutually exclusive and exhaustive events, which are B1 and B2, transmitting 0 and transmitting 1. Probability of transmitting 0 is equal to 0.4, and probability of transmitting 1 is 1 minus 0.4 is equal to 0.6. Now, conditional probability of new information event A when B1 has been occurred, means probability of receiving 1 as given that transmitting 0 is equal to 0.05, and probability of receiving 1 when 1 is transmitted is equal to 0.90. In the next column, we find the condition or probability of simultaneous occurrence of event B1A and B2A, which is equal to this one. And in the final column, we find the posterior probability or revised probability of a specific event B2 when event A is already done.